This is a web browser on a Samsung Galaxy Watch. The web browser is a very unique app when you think about it. It's nearly limitless in its usefulness, with countless websites, web apps, communication tools, and more, all nearly instantly accessible with it. So when a device has a web browser, it has the ultimate super app, an app for doing almost anything. So does this principle remain true when we add a web browser to one of the smallest smart device form factors? First, to be clear, what I am using here on my Galaxy Watch is an official web browser app made by Samsung. I'm not using any sort of side-loaded APK or other workaround to get a web browser on this smartwatch. This official Samsung browser app is available for Wear OS Galaxy Watches in the Google Play Store, and this app also works with other Wear OS smartwatches such as the Google Pixel Watch, which I've used it with previously. So what can you actually do with a web browser on a Galaxy Watch? Basic web browsing does work, but you'll quickly notice what the main challenge of this is. The web just isn't designed for use on a smartwatch. Every website seems to assume you're on a smartphone and adjust itself accordingly as though you have a 2 or 3 inch wide screen. But when that is then condensed to about a 1.25 inch diameter screen of the Galaxy Watch, buttons become very, very small, requiring excellent precision by you, the user, and text becomes quite challenging to read. Also, the Galaxy Watch has a screen shape of a circle, and the web is designed for viewing on a device with a rectangular screen, so web pages are cropped to the circle shape. Samsung's browser app has two ways to overcome this problem. By default, you can swipe in from where the corner would be to move the viewing area to access the corner. Or you can enable zoom mode, letting you use the bezel or on-screen buttons to zoom out so you can see nearly to the corners. But now you've made the web page even tinier. As far as browsing the web, it's mostly straightforward. Tap on a button or link to use it. Tap a text field to open the keyboard. Swipe from the left edge to the right to go back a page. And swipe from the right edge to the left to go forward a page. There is a menu when you swipe up from the bottom, where you'll also find the back and forward buttons, as well as an option to save your current page to your bookmarks, a show on phone option to open the web page you're viewing on your phone, an option to view your bookmarks, and the zoom mode option discussed earlier. There are some scenarios one could envision using this web browser even with the challenges. Perhaps you want to quickly check the score of a sports game, a quick Google search on your Galaxy Watch, and there's the info you need. Or you could do some quick reading of a Wikipedia article, and your phone and laptop just aren't nearby. This is possible, though you'll need to be okay with the rather tiny text. You can even watch YouTube videos on your Galaxy Watch with the web browser app, and by default, audio plays through the built-in speaker. If you have Bluetooth earbuds paired with your watch, audio will play through those instead. YouTube does run quite slow on the Galaxy Watch though, so the experience is not the greatest. There are other things you can try as well, such as a simple web app and game, though you'll likely need to get used to moving the viewing area to access buttons in the corner, as well as reading tiny text. Now, this is all as the web browser app and the web stand today. And again, the challenges faced seems to be that websites just are not designed for such a small form factor. But what if they were? To answer this, we'll need to build our own website designed for use on a smartwatch and see what it's like. To envision what a web experience designed for smartwatches would look like, we'll need to first understand what a good user interface and user experience would require. Based on our experience with the web as it stands today, as well as reviewing Google's design guidelines for Wear OS smartwatch apps, our smartwatch-friendly website should follow these three guidelines. First, it should be designed for use on a device with a circle-shaped screen. Unlike our experience with the web today, where the content is cropped and hidden due to the round screen shape, all essential buttons and info must be visible on our smartwatch-friendly website. Second, font sizes and elements should be properly sized for readability and usability on the smaller screen size. And third, the website should be lightweight and load fast to ensure it can run well on the limited computing resources of a smartwatch. As far as the technology behind building this website, we'll use the standard coding languages for simple websites, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. We'll target two unique use cases. First, a web page for reading content on a smartwatch, like as if you were reading a news article or other informational article on the web. The second use case will be a simple, interactive web app, a basic score tracking app. And here is the website I've designed for a smartwatch. I've made this homepage a very simple list, much like what you'd find in a smartwatch app. The first thing we'll look at is the sample web article I designed. As you can see, this has been designed with the circle smartwatch shape in mind, ensuring text and important elements are not cropped out. The text size has been increased to ensure it is readable on the small screen of a smartwatch. The background is black with light-colored text, and text is hyphenated so more words can fit per line. We'll next look at the Score Tracker website app I created. This simple web app lets you keep the score between two players and also has an undo button. The Samsung browser app even lets websites save data locally. So I've made this website that even if I close the browser and then reopen the browser, once I navigate back to this website, it will remember the last entered score. With this simple web app, we can see how even more complex websites with interactivity and save data could be created to work in the Samsung browser app. So, is the smartwatch the next platform for browsing the web and using web apps? Maybe. The websites and web apps will need to be redesigned for this smaller form factor before we see any widespread adoption. That said, with how flexible the existing web platform is, I think I've shown it is already technologically possible to design websites for smartwatches. Final note, if you're interested in viewing the website I built for yourself on your smartwatch, you can find a link to it in the video description. Thanks for watching. Until next time.